How about a disease that comes with morbid obesity, chronic inflammation, excessive urination and thirst, makes you deaf, makes you blind, gives you kidney failure, will lead to amputations of your toes and even your feet, and gives you a 95% chance of dying of a heart attack? 16% of adult Americans have this disease now and are on medical treatments for the disease. Another 38% of American adults are in the processes of developing this disease. Some of them are already on medication to try and slow down the progress. So that means 54% of adult Americans or either have or are developing type 2 diabetes. In this video, I'm going to explain to you what it is, why it has reached such epidemic proportions, and tell you what you can do about it, even though there is no medical cure. No medical cure. There's no medication that is going to cure you. But there is a way of preventing it and reversing it. So welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew. I'm a nutritionist. And I was a little way down the road towards developing this. I'm not going to lie. I was becoming obese and I was starting to have heart problems. And fortunately, I caught it early enough and I am now a lot healthier. So, what is type 2 diabetes? It's a disease. The full name is called diabetes mellitus. And there are two types, type 1, type 2. Type 1 is genetic. There's nothing you can do about it. You just have to manage it with medication. It's a very, very small proportion of the population. Of all the people who have diabetes, it's about 1 to 1.5% are type 1. The rest, almost 99%, it's type 2 diabetes, which is not genetic. It is a dietary disease. It develops over a period of time, and it is caused by eating too much sugar or too much carbohydrate, which is what sugar is. Sugar is carbohydrate, so it doesn't have to just be sweet sugar that you use to sweeten your food. It's glucose in all its forms, including starch, and all starch is just glucose. That's what starch is. And our diet now is so high in starches, grains, and we eat so much bread and pasta and potato and rice and corn and oats, and in addition to all the sweet stuff. And the processed stuff, which has extra sugar injected into it to make it taste nice, to keep us addicted, and to all the processed drinks and sugary fruit drinks and soft drinks. And we are just eating way too much sugar. And when you eat too much sugar, your insulin level goes up. Insulin is a hormone produced in your pancreas, and it is a growth hormone, but it is also a hormone needed to, as part of the process, to metabolize sugar. So if you eat more sugar, or more glucose, and your blood glucose goes up, then you need to produce more insulin. And high chronic insulin leads to a condition called hyperinsulinemia, or insulin resistance, where your body no longer responds correctly to the insulin, and then you start to develop blood sugar issues, which eventually lead to diabetes. And when you have diabetes, full-blown diabetes, you're not processing sugar anymore, you're producing way too much body fat, you can't burn the fat off, and you stop producing insulin, and so you go into physical shock, and it can kill you very, very quickly if you don't then go on to the medication, which, as I said earlier, is not a cure. There's medication to keep you alive, but not to reverse the disease. So millions of people are diabetic, millions of people are injecting themselves with insulin every day because their bodies are no longer producing insulin. Other people who are pre-diabetic are on medication to try and break down the sugars in their blood so that their need for insulin is reduced. But none of these things actually cure it. So if we want to deal with this, we need to understand how it works. And what is the history of this? Diabetes is not a new thing. It's been around, it's in the literature from over 2,000 years ago. Ancient Greeks, ancient Romans, they knew about it. They used to actually give it names like honey urine, because ants would be attracted to the urine of somebody who had this disease. And that's because of all the sugar in the urine, because the body is desperately trying to get rid of the sugar, which it cannot process without insulin. And in the sort of early 1900s, treatments were, ideas were developed in the medical community where if the patient is peeing out all this sugar, obviously sugar is part of the problem, let's try feeding them a diet without sugar. So patients in hospitals were fed on low carbohydrate or zero carbohydrate diets, and some of them recovered and were sent home. Others died, as was the standard, because it does kill you. And nobody understood why some died and some recovered, but hey, some recovered, it's better than nothing. We understand that now, because now we understand that the ones who recovered were the type 2 diabetics, and they were reversing the dietary damage by eating the right diet and reversing out the whole process, and their bodies started to produce insulin again. The type 1 diabetics, who were genetically incapable of producing insulin, a dietary intervention doesn't help. That worked for about 40 years, saving some people by cutting sugar out of their diet. And it was a standard approach until insulin was discovered, and insulin was then produced and started to be administered to people who were diabetic, because the understanding arrived that the people who were diabetic were not producing insulin. And when you inject people with insulin, they don't die as quickly. So the deaths in the hospitals went way down, and everybody was really happy that they discovered a medication that could save the lives of the diabetes sufferers. Not cure them, but save their lives, at least for now. And the whole idea of the low carbohydrate, low sugar diet just kind of sort of went out of memory. And so most people were not dying of diabetes anymore, but they were very sick and they were not recovering, and they were on medications and injecting themselves with insulin for the rest of their lives. And that is still the case today. So the reason that it's happening today is because, I'm going to read you something here. In the early 2000s, the American Diabetic Association wanted to produce what it would consider to be, recommend the optimal diet for diabetes sufferers. So here we go. Dr. Richard Kahn, who was the chief medical and scientific officer of the American Diabetes Association, and this is a quote: "When you look at the literature," he means the scientific literature talking about diet, "when you look at the literature, it is so weak," and then went ahead and recommended the standard American government dietary guidelines anyway, which is low-fat, high-carbohydrate diet. In the absence of any other idea, just went with that. At least now, in the American Diabetic Association site, and you have to go through a lot of it to find it, it's in the small print, it does say, "For individuals with type 2 diabetes, low or very low carbohydrate diets are a viable approach where reducing medications is a priority." That is saying low carb diet will help if you don't want to be on medication for the rest of your life. Surely that's a priority. Where reducing medications is a priority. For who would that not be a priority? Surely, to goodness, nobody wants to be on medication for the rest of their life. But it's just there, sort of buried in amongst all the other stuff about the drugs and the insulin and all the other treatments. And why? I'll tell you why. Because medical associations, and I mean all of them, are generally funded by big pharmaceutical companies. And a pharmaceutical company has no interest in a dietary resolution to any kind of disease, because that's not the business they're in. They're in the business of producing medications. So when your sponsor, who's paying you all your money, is the producer of the medication and recommending to you and your members that you promote the medication, that's sort of where you're going to be focusing your mind. And as for the government food guidelines that still to this day recommend low-fat, high-carbohydrate diets, those guidelines, which are actually reviewed technically every 5 years, fall under the jurisdiction of the US Department of Agriculture. The Department of Agriculture. Can you imagine the Department of Agriculture trying to tell people to cut down on their carbohydrates and their starches? And then that's not going to happen. So diabetes, type 2 diabetes, is absolutely reversible. It really is. Anything between a month and 6 months for most people, it is completely reversible, or at least partially reversible, and certainly manageable. Your weight will come down, your risk of heart disease will come down, you won't have your feet amputated, you won't go blind, you won't go deaf, and you won't have kidney failure, and you won't be spending $300 to $500 every single month on insulin injections. And remember that type 2 diabetes is actually caused by overproduction of insulin. So where, on what planet, does it make sense to inject yourself with the very chemical that caused the disease in the first place? It's mind-bogglingly nonsensical. This book by Dr. Jason Fung, The Diabetes Code, is an excellent book. If you're inclined to want to read a book on diabetes and diabetes research and diabetes treatment. So I'm going to name this book in the video description notes down below here. I'm also going to link to the video that I did on insulin quite recently, which explains it in a little bit more detail and how you can manage your insulin level to lower your risk of developing diabetes. And I'm going to put a link to my video about diet and the food that works for a lot of people in terms of maintaining your weight, not becoming obese, not developing diabetes, and lowering your risk of heart disease. So thank you very much for watching this video, and I wish you all the best. And if you are suffering from pre-diabetes or even full-blown diabetes, there is hope. Even though your medication can't cure you, you can cure yourself with management of your nutrition and your diet. Talk to your doctor, do it with your doctor so that you can coordinate. You can't just stop your medications and change your food because you are sick. So that needs to be dealt with very, very carefully in conjunction with a health professional who you really trust. If you're not diabetic and you're not on any medication, you're fine. You can change your eating and you will reverse this process. It's absolutely fully reversible, but it is a nasty, nasty, nasty disease. 95% of people with diabetes die of a heart attack, but a lot of them have their feet amputated and go blind and have kidney failure before they have the heart attack, and you don't want that. So thank you very much for watching. Please subscribe, please like the video, please share this. Please share this video with anybody you think needs to understand how serious this epidemic actually is.